Yo, check it out. It's your boy Fonzo. That was just a little small preview, a thumb on my No Limit Records collection. I got way more than that. You know, even we'll go over to the DVD section. You know, these are all the No Limit movies from the old to the new, you know. I mean, this blog is entitled basically No Limit Forever. And you know what it means to me, No Limit Forever, coming back to the rap game. I'ma have to take y'all on a little story and go back right to the beginning. Now it was about probably about 96 or something, out here in the UK where I'm from, Birmingham, England. You know, I grew up listening to hip-hop, Ice-T, you know, N.W.A., all the hardcore music and stuff like that, Big Daddy Kane, everybody like that. And I mean, I used to be a heavy East Coast listener. You know, I used to listen to East Coast music a lot. You know, Prodigy, Boot Camp Click, Redman, Method Man, Def Squad, Wu-Tang, all of that. You know what I'm talking about? I didn't really know much about West Coast, or let alone the South, you know what I'm saying? So I remember there was a big influx out here where all the street niggas, all the hustlers, everybody used to listen to No Limit. And you know, through some of my big homies, I used to hear this, you know, this No Limit music. I used to hear like some Master P and that. And you know, listening to the East Coast music and the music that I used to listen to then, it was all about lyrics, it was all about punchlines, it was all about beats. I mean, the first time, I'm gonna be honest, the first time I heard a Master P record, I was like, you know, what's this, turn this off, you know what I mean? But secretly, I must have been digging this shit, because I found myself like going away and listening to it myself. And I'll say what really gripped me about it wasn't so much the hardcore element of the music, but it was all the, like, the real songs, the Mr. President, the, you know, the TIUs, all of that shit, you know what I mean? Heaven for a Gangster, Would You Take a Bullet for Your Homies, you know, all those kind of tracks is what really got me pumping and made me just open up my ears and really start listening to No Limit. Because what I found about Master P and No Limit's records, it wasn't just the hardcore music, it wasn't just the rowdy music, it was stuff that was real to, that most people could relate with. You know, it was social commentary, it was talking about injustices, it was making you think about certain things, and that was really the pinnacle of it. I mean, my No Limit CD collection is kind of heavy, and you know, from when I started listening to No Limit, that was it. Anything people out, I copped. Anything that had the No Limit tank on the back, anything that had that kind of stamp on it, I used to put it out. Even if I didn't like the artist, I still bought the CD, you know what I mean? And where I'm from, we used to pay £20 for a CD on import. Now, you know, in US dollars at that time, that would have probably been about 30 something dollars, probably even 40 at the exchange rate then. So you can imagine paying that much for a CD, but we're paying £20 straight import every week, because only certain CDs used to carry No Limit and that. So I built up my collection, you know, DVDs, everything. People used to come to me for the No Limit and shit like that, and you know, I was kind of known as that. And especially being a musician myself, a rapper, it influenced me real heavy, No Limit Records, because it was independent, black owned. You know, I was looking at Master P. Other people used to listen to Jay-Z, they used to listen to all these other rappers. I'm not knocking them, they didn't know nothing about Master P. And I used to be like, yo, you know, P more successful than all them dudes, because he went out there, you know, they tried to give him a sucker deal. You know, he ended up getting 85%, something he used to always talk about on his tracks and that as well. And I used to listen to that and think, you know, this is an intelligent dude. And you know, you listen to so much people in the rap game and you take their music and listen to it and think, yeah, that's hot. But P was actually somebody that, outside of the music, I could hear him in an interview and everything he says, it would resonate. And I think, you know what, that's real. I could tell he was a decent brother, you know what I mean? Even down to you know, a lot of the charity work and stuff like that. He'd be doing the business and that and all of that. He was like, you know what, this is a stand-up guy that's really out there doing his, taking care of his family. And, you know, I got nothing but respect. So, you know, there's been periods where No Limit's come off the scene. You had the new No Limit. You know, I was there to support that. You know, that kind of started from Game Face. The first time I picked up that CD, I was kind of like, you know, what's really going on? But I didn't really understand the growth of the label, the business side of things. You know, P was breaking up into a whole nother playing field that people weren't even ready for. So whereas a lot of people were listening to his music, and it wasn't what they expect. I mean, Game Face was like 14 tracks. You used to picking up a No Limit CD, getting 20-something tracks on there. You got the hardcore music, you got hella artists, it's that rowdy shit. But, you know, Game Face was actually before its time. When I listen to it now, I can listen to the album straight through because I understand the growth of it. And I mean, new No Limit, you know, you had the gutter music. But I think now we're looking at a position where I could see No Limit coming back as strong as it was, if not stronger, because there's a lot of youth. You know, P's in tune with the youth, which is one thing that a lot of people that get older in the game, or they get, you know, they don't get more mature. He's a guy that's matured, he's a lot more intelligent, he's got the business mind, the business savvy, but he's still in touch and in tune with the youth. He's out there doing projects with the kids and stuff like that. You know, you got a whole selection of artists, Benji, you know, T-Bow. You know, Rome is out there doing his thing, and I mean, to me, nothing but good things I can see coming, and you know, I'm gonna be supporting the tank. You know, and me as a rapper myself, I ain't even trying to put myself over, but since I started rapping, it's always been my lifelong kind of dream or inspiration to get down with the tank and put it down, you know what I mean? And over the years, I've built those connections, you know, I've collaborated with, you know, Dino West from the gutter side, you know, Official when they were heavy with the tank, you know, more recently G5J, so the Shocker's boy, you know, and you know, I'm pushing these links, I'm pushing, because I really want to get No Limit popping out here in the UK like I know it could, because a lot of people out here in the UK love No Limit. It's just like when I said we used to be buying CDs for £20, and that wasn't even the retail price, but other people would be caking off it on top, you know what I mean? And I think if we push something and brand something out here, European talk, open the market, you know what I mean? That's me, that's what I'm saying, and I'm ready to put that work in, you know what I mean? I ain't even saying I want a deal or I want paper or I want this, you know, I'm ready to put that work in for the tank, you know what I mean? Because I can see, you know, something that's kind of always, you know, it might sound crazy, but I see Master P's always been like an inspiration to me, you know. I got the book, stuff like that. Even way before that, I'm a type of cat. I've been listening to interviews, peeping games, because that's where you get the game from. You get the game from the OGs. So this year, 2011, I see big things going on for the tank. And, you know, whether I'm a part of it or not, you know, inshallah, hopefully I'm going to be a part of it. You know, if not, I'm going to still be supporting like I always been doing. You know, my collection going to grow, whether digital, CD, you know. And, you know, I'm check advise all y'all to stay tuned. Check out the tank. No Limit forever. You know, it's moving. The movement's popping. You can see it's official. There's a lot of things going down. And, you know, there's only one way to go with it, and that's to the top. You know, like P said, there ain't no limits. You know what I mean? Master P said, do the damn thing. Ain't no limits. A good run beats a bad stand. Words of wisdom to keep up in your mind frame. You ain't got it, go get it. Nigga, get on the ground, man. Ain't no denying. Sometimes the deck seems stacked. Pressure don't ease back, especially for them street cats. About that, I ain't see where the team at. It ain't where you're from, it's how you come and where you be at. I'm tired of being cool like I usually do. Ask about the kid, they tell you do be true. Want beef, I just holler out hooty hoo. And let some shots out the K hit you Rudy Poos. You know, a little something, but No Limit forever. It's your boy Fonzo. Check me out.